Get ready to match the stars from Our Magazine, Gary Collins, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Aiders and Officers and Richardson, Richard Paul, and from Flo, Joyce Guillemont, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
You may be seated.
So nice to see you, Commodore.
We are happy to see you, too.
Can you explain this? Three birds, is it?
Eros?
What's that?
Eros?
Three ducks.
Are there any Latin students in the group?
Two.
With erotic speed.
With what?
Erotic speed.
Erotic speed?
No, that's erratic speed.
I know what the birds mean.
What?
If you can't soar like eagles, you must be working with a bunch of turkeys.
Hello, John and Linda. We welcome you once again. Linda, please refresh our memories about your home and your life and all of that sort of thing.
I'm from Birmingham, Alabama. I recently finished medical school, and I'm currently in training to be a neurologist.
Yes. Is your back better, Gary?
Not yet.
Yes. Can you work on Gary's back?
Certainly.
The nerve part of it. Nothing else. You know, just the nerve part of his
back.
Okay.
Well, she's studying to be a neurologist.
And John has lived in many places, but he's living here in Los Angeles now, right?
I live in San Gabriel.
San Gabriel. That's Orange County, is it?
I don't know.
Really getting off today, aren't we?
I've only lived here a year.
Yeah. I don't want to talk to you anymore, John. Whose is this?
Mine.
Yours?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is that A or B?
B.
Oh, you're getting better, John. All right. Middle of round one, second game. Fat Frida is so fat. She could hide a blank in her dress.
I feel provocative.
All right.
And I want to get letters.
You'll get one from me, I'll tell you that, John. All right, here we go. John, Fat Frida's so fat, she could hide a blank in her dress.
Elephant.
All right, something big.
Well, that's
elephant
fat.
Is a rather large animal.
I didn't see the tin drum that Brett was talking about, but I did see the Hindenburg, a dirigible.
Aha! Boy, that would really be fat.
Boy, in the space age, that's really up to date, isn't it?
He's an older man.
But older.
No. Heffalumps, no dirigibles, a car.
All right. So far, we have
the wonderful answer, sweetheart.
My answer is called How to Get Hate Mail to a Parent. Priest.
Would you like to explain that?
Is there anything else we would have to know about that?
No, I mean, it's as stupid as the question.
All right. She could hide a blank in her dress.
When I was pregnant, everybody said, she's carrying a watermelon, so.
Watermelon. Uh-huh. Is that the joke they do now?
Yeah.
They say the obvious things, don't they?
Oh, don't they?
Yeah. Because it didn't look like a watermelon when I saw her. What do you say there, Richard? Looked like a basketball.
I was going to, yes.
Oh!
Well, it's the first match.
He said
the words right out of my mouth.
Right. And
not,
you?
Not a car, not a dirigible, not, what did you say? A priest. Not a watermelon, not a...
Basketball.
Wonderful memory.
But, yes, wasn't that good? I just wanted to show you my memory.
Yeah. Yeah.
But a watermelon farm.
That's large.
Well, she had more time to think about it than we did.
All right, let's go to round two. Score is tied, zip to zip. Linda went first last time, so John, you go first this time.
Let's try B again.
B it is. Pete said, my kid is really dumb. You're going to have to be a little more alert if you want to stay for the rest of this show. He's really dumb. I told him to keep his turtle in a bowl, so this morning I found that lousy turtle in my blank.
The B.
Two or three good choices here. Here we go. Yeah. Pete said, my kid is really dumb. I told him to keep his turtle in a bowl. So this morning I found that lousy turtle in my blank.
In my hot tub.
In my hot tub. Hot tub.
Hot tub.
You really got used to California and the California ways very quickly, because this is the hot tub capital of the world out here. Everybody has a hot tub. They're always doing it. What
doing
do you say?
What?
Beg your pardon.
Jumping in their hot tubs, jumping in and out of hot tubs. It's all I do out here, jump in and out of hot tubs.
John, I don't know what temperature yours is at, but I said toilet bowl.
Toilet bowl.
Simple euphemism for toilet bowl, John. I'm sorry.
John, all right. Two of those.
No, I didn't.
I said toilet, Gene. Toilet.
Okay, Chuck. Anything you say.
Toilet.
The two reds you're wearing clash, Chuck. The red of your bandana and your hat clash with the red of your shirt. Yes?
I found him in my cereal bowl.
Cereal bowl. That's a good answer.
Found it right where this show is going.
Yes, sir. All right, Jerse.
Found it crawling around her Rice Krispies.
Cereal. So we had two of those. All right. Now, Linda, this puts you in a good spot. All you will need to do is match one, and you will have won the game. We can't do it now. Now we have to do this. All right. This is the last question of the last round, Linda. It's all yours. Remember, all you have to do is match one. Carl said, this weather is really terrible. I'm sorry. You're fired. Get out. It's your last chance now. Carl said, this weather is really terrible. Medic!
I'm going home.
It's so hot, Howard Cosell had to put a sweatband on his blank.
I'm going home.
Nope.
Apparently not. I can't see your keys at all.
He doesn't have one either. No, all right. Oh, yeah, now you're this now we can see it. Jeff Clark. Linda, Carl said this weather is really terrible. It's so hot. Howard Cosell had to put a sweatband on his blank.
To pay?
To pay. There is one more amusing answer than that that comes to my mind, Linda. I hope someone over here said toupee for her sake. What do you say?
I hope so, too. I didn't. However, a little lower, just below the nose, and there's Howard's tongue.
Tongue! Put a sweatband on his tongue. What have you got there?
I'm sorry. I said on his little mouthpiece.
On his mouth. What do you say, Tonto?
I didn't say anything, Gene.
You didn't say anything?
I just drew an arrow.
All right, thank you very much. Now, Linda, if you'd come down here and stand on the blue dot, please. We'll see how you do with the big super match here where you can win over $10,000. John, you have $500. Happy birthday to your wife. Thanks for being here on Match Game. John Curry, ladies and gentlemen. Ready. Good. There you go. We polled the studio audience not too long ago. Nice, smart bunch, a little slow like these. And we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank, no return. $500 for you if you match the answer they gave us most often. For matching the second most popular answer, $250. And then for matching the third, $100. Now, I caution you. Only call on the ones who are trying to get your attention. If you call on someone who's looking, that person doesn't have an answer, you see. All right?
Joyce has an answer.
Yeah.
Yes,
we didn't.
Well, you don't have to go, it's a good one this time, maybe.
Yeah. We'll be the judge of that.
Point of no return.
Point of no return. Who else is trying to get your attention?
Richard.
I thought I was going to die. No deposit.
No deposit, no return. Anyone else trying to get your attention? Now, wait a minute. Chuck is looking at you. Chuck is looking at you.
Chuck.
What? I'm a cowboy, as most people know.
They like coming, I want to go home.
And one of the cutest things happened in the corral. We let one of the guys ride away, and he said the opposite of what General MacArthur said. He wasn't too smart. He said, I no return.
May I say something?
And some said he had Indian blood in him.
Yes, I no return. So you I no return, no deposit, no return. And and point of no return. You want one of those or one of your own?
No deposit, no return.
No deposit, no return.
This is going to be close.
Well, now I'm curious to see what that audience gave as a third answer. Let's see the $100 response. Land of no return.
It's America this year.
That's, you've ever heard of that phrase before? I haven't heard of that. Well, there are a bunch of dummies here that day. All right, let's see. Take a look at the next one, please. No deposit, no return. There's yours. You've got it. $250 for you. And I suspect on top it'll be point of no return. The answer that Joyce gave you. Slide
river.
The big one.
River.
Yes, you're wrong. Point of no return. All right. Listen, you got $250. That means the least you'll play for is $2,500. However, we want you to spin that star wheel and see if you can double that to $10,000. Linda, get up there and grab a peg and give it a whirl.
Five,
go.
Five, Gene. Five. Five. Five.
5,000. 5,000. What did I say? 10. Oh. Did it make one complete revolution?
No.
Is anybody watching? Did not.
Spin it again.
All right, you got to grab the peg and spin it a little bit harder. Don't strain yourself. Don't get up. You know, we're not covered. We have no insurance here. So. That's twice in a row for Joyce.
Three times in a row.
All
she
right.
knows when she's got a winner.
Yes, of course. All right, face me if you would, please. Good luck to you for $2,500. Defense blank. Want to take a look at it? Defense blank. You want to see it? All right. Joyce agonized over it and finally got one. Now you give us the answer that she has on the card, Linda, and we give you $2,500. What do you say? Defense blank.
Defense corps. I can't, sorry.
You can't. She drew a blank. Defense corps,
that's
she
tough
said.
To do.
What do you say?
I said, I'm sorry, I didn't say that. I said defense mechanism.
Defense mechanism.
Budget.
Defense, Secretary of Defense would be the opposite.
Defense.
But Defense Department was the first thing that came to my mind, although that too is the department.
That is the answer.
Defense Attorney. That's a good one, audience.
I've got
very
one,
good.
Gene.
Yeah.
How about defense needs mending?
Defense needs mending, yes. Very good, Saul. Now. Linda, thank you for being here with us at Match Game. We're going to do a little business with America, and we'll start another game with another team right after this. Here comes Patty Simpson and Howard Pittman. Hello there. Welcome to both of you.
Thank you.
Nice to see your smiling faces here. Patty, let's find out about you.
I'm Patty Simpson from Houston, Texas, where I teach high school psychology to 11th and 12th graders.
Really? What do you teach them in psychology?
Defense mechanisms.
Oh, really?
Defense mechanisms.
It's in the back seat of the car. Is it those kind of defense mechanisms?
Sometimes, but not always.
All right, Patty, good luck to you. And Howard, let's hear about you, please.
I'm from Roanoke Park, California. That's about 40 miles north of San Francisco in Sonoma County. I've been married for 38 years, and I have 4 children and 12 grandchildren.
What did you do for a living?
I'm a retired bus driver.
Ah, well, nice to have you with us. Good luck to
Thank
both
you.
Of you. Patty, you may go first. Choose A or B.
A, please.
A it is for Patty, and here we go. Fred said, I'll tell you why I fired that smart aleck interior decorator.
Mm.
He told me that my blank clashed with the drapes. That's why I fired him. Very colorful.
This was made by Fritz. Fritz made this for me and he said, I've got wonderful material for you with two hands on it.
My mother sent me my blanket.
Your mother sent
that? My mother sent this to me.
That was kind of her.
She didn't like what I was wearing.
Really?
No, she did.
Where does she live?
San Francisco.
Oh, yeah.
You took my heart away.
Here we go, Patty. Fred said, I'll tell you why I fired that smart aleck interior decorator. He told me that my blank clashed with the drapes.
My clothes?
My clothes?
That's the best I could do.
Really?
Yes, sir.
There's one pretty good answer that came to my mind. Maybe someone up here thought of it. Gary?
First, I thought of skin, but that was a little icky.
So yes.
Then I said hair.
Hair? On a personal note, yes?
Well, he was crazy about this person. He really was very much in love with her. He married her. His wife.
My wife. Yes.
That's
is that an amusing answer? You find that amusing, Patty? Good.
Touching.
Yes. Charles?
Touching story.
Boy, that's bad acting. Rugs.
The rugs.
Snake.
Arrogant.
Obvious.
Yes, you are very self-conscious about that. Yeah, here we go.
Rugs?
He told me that my wife clothes clashed with the drapes, according to Patty Simpson.
Well, I figured she was a psychology teacher, so that my personality clashed.
My personality.
Good.
Good.
You know, clashing.
She's got a nice young one. The happiest loser we've had here in a long time, isn't it?
She's a happy loser.
Yeah. All right.
Well, this is a true story. My decorator is a beautiful woman who was my high school teacher.
Yes.
And she said that my wife clashed, so my wife moved out and she moved in.
Uh-huh. And you...
Just kidding. Just kidding.
All right, Joyce.
I knew a lady. No, I did truly. There was a very famous actress who had her whole house decorated white. And she wore white, and she got a perfect suntan, and she had a little dachshund dog who was exactly the color as her skin. And she used to make a late entrance to her dinner party with the dachshund on the leash, looking divine. And when she got tired of the white scheme, she got rid of her dog, too. Isn't that awful?
Oh, that's terrible.
Anyway,
okay.
Terrible.
We'll see you later. All right. Okay. Have we got a finish for this?
No. Carry her out.
Ah, come on. You're a good man, Charlie Brown. Listen, we never heard your answer.
Patty Duke called.
Patty Duke called?
She said all the acting smells.
You're going to show us your answer, right?
It isn't worth it.
She's a man. He told me that my hair clashed with the drapes. And Patty Simpson was looking for a different answer. All right. Now, Howard, we're going to have another question for you in a moment or so, but right now, this for you, if you please. Thank you. Oh, really?
Yeah.
No kidding. What? You know what she's going to do? A 2-hour TV special, and her baby is going to appear on camera. How old will the baby be?
Oh, no. In the
2 hours
show,
older.
I have a baby. But the baby's premature, so mine is too big.
Oh, I see.
That's a big 2-hour special.
Yeah. Well, we'll look forward to seeing that.
Brett's expecting, you know, and she's going on That's Incredible.
That's every 1,000 years or so, there has to be an immaculate conception.
It happens now.
And
not immaculate.
We're getting close to the year 2000. Now, speaking of that, you've got, what's the name of your show again?
Our Magazine. Comes on in September.
Our Magazine.
H-O-U-R.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, this show is already in October. We're in October
well,
right now.
Well, and I've been on for about a month and a half.
That's
it's
right.
A wonderful show. I really enjoy it.
And you're wonderful.
Yes. Terrific.
Fabulous.
Gee, and next week we'll know who the president is.
That's right. I'm Gene Rayburn. Join us next time for the Match Game. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive Westminster Crazy Automatic Corn Popper. Stirs itself to give you big, fluffy, great-tasting popcorn, 6 quarts in 6 minutes. And relaxing at home, drink sparkling pink champagne. Any day when you feel special, tastes like bubbly wine. Pink champagne malt liquor from Iroquois Brands. A cosmetic bag and Nestle Streaks and Tips, temporary spray-on hair color. Streak your hair, tip it, frost it, go blonde, go silver in minutes without bleaching or dyeing. A picnic jug, and now for a tasty change of pace, Lemon Tree, the lemonade-flavored drink mix from Lipton in low-calorie and regular. A calculator and Raid House and Garden Bug Killer. Kills bugs dead indoors and outdoors, yet won't harm most plants or shrubs. And a baby bath and changing pad and Diaperine baby wash cloths with a special moisture-packed formula to clean and condition baby skin. Keep your baby better and clean with Diaperine. Pet and Vaporette pet collars protects your dog or cat against ticks and fleas. All three Pet and Vaporette collars wear the good housekeeping seal. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program is edited for broadcast.